Thank you so much for joining me on The Property Show. Well, market data, scientific advice and reporter stories which tell you what's going on in India's real estate across the country. Lots lined up as Amir and I help you make the most of your real estate investments. And before we begin, here's a look at the menu, what we have lined up for you. A special report on the new markets of Eastern Mumbai district and its potential as an affordable realty hub. There are, of course, properties culled out in various budgets across the country. Mumbai at 2 crores, Pune is 75 lakhs, what can you buy? Gurgaon at 2 crores, what are your top picks? Noida 60 lakhs, prime property, Chennai 45 to 50 lakhs and Bangalore at 60 lakhs, what's worth your money? Of course, before we start, it's Monday, so here's a wrap of all the news which affects real estate. And of course, the first one isn't particularly good news, but of course, we've got lined up a really good debate on that subject as well. Take a look.
A research report by property consultants Knight Frank India has revealed that the sales of 25 listed real estate companies has dropped to almost half over the past 2 years. While North India has emerged as the worst hit, its southern counterparts continue to record stable performance. The findings also reveal that residential property prices across major cities have also doubled in the last couple of years. According to leading newspaper dailies, the Hiranandani Group has emerged as the highest bidder for Hirco PLC's township in Chennai, which was put up on auction by HDFC to recover its dues. As per the reports, the Mumbai-based developer has bid about 600 crore rupees for the Chennai property, spread over nearly 158 acres in Kanchipuram on the outskirts of the city. Several thousand flat purchasers were left high and dry because of a family dispute, which stalled work on both Chennai and Panvel projects for over a year. Niranjan Hiranandani was the chairman of Hirco before he stepped down in 2010. The Uttar Pradesh Housing and Development Board has planned to increase rates of its properties and plots across the state by around 16% with effect from April 1st. The board increases rates of its properties annually depending on the demand and supply gap in different localities. The rates are hiked depending on the type and location of property, ranging between 5 and 25% in different districts of UP. In some cases where there is high demand for properties, rates have been increased by up to 25%. The much-awaited 42-kilometer-long Phase 1 of Namma Metro has got a new deadline. While a couple of stretches on Phase 1 are already functional, Bangalore Metro officials claim that the entire stretch will be completely operational by 2015 against the previous schedule for completion by December 2013. Godrej Properties has partnered with a local builder to develop a residential project at Old Mahabalipuram Road in Chennai. The proposed project, spread over 7 acres, will offer approximately 1 million square feet of saleable area and will be developed as a modern group housing residential development comprising 1, 2 and 3 BHK apartments.
We'll head to the west and take our callers and viewers' questions. Pune, Mumbai and Thane are some of the micro markets we'll cover. Neeraj Bhargav on the phone line with us. First up, Neeraj, welcome to the show. Go ahead.
Hi, good evening. Ma'am, I have a couple of queries. Mm-hmm. I have shortlisted one project in Pune. The developer's name is Sky Eye Developers and the project name is Songbirds. It is located in Bhugaon area near Chandni Chowk in Pune. Mm-hmm. My questions are that how is Sky Eye Developer as a developer, and I would also like to know your feedback regarding the project Songbirds.
Okay.
And what is the future scope for Bhugaon as an area, and what is the growth scope that you see?
All right. So Bhugaon, it's a new market. So you'll have to, of course, describe it to us in a little bit more detail. Pune, as we've already said, is a great market. So developer, again, a new one. We've not yet analyzed him as well, Sameer.
So basically, Bhugaon actually was a cluster of villages. And it was located. It's located just off the Mumbai-Bangalore expressway, the NH4 really. It's only 5 kilometers from Kothrud. And Kothrud is now a very well-established secondary market. A lot of IT professionals stay there. The prices over there have jumped up quite a bit over the last 3-4 years.
You'd call it affordable to mid-market, or it's like...
We can't call it affordable
at all.
So
mid to premium.
It's 5,000 to 7,000 rupees per square foot
range.
For
Pune, that's
for
premium.
Pune, yeah, that's what I wouldn't even get there now.
<It's premium. laughs>
Because Pune is luxury is 9,000 to 20,000 now.
Okay.
It's gone, it's become literally a new segment called luxury has emerged in Pune over the last 3 years. The other advantage of this area is that it's got a lot of green belts. So it's very livable and it's very green, this area. There's a Manas Lake also. There's some panoramic hills also surrounding this area. So right. It makes it very scenic. Coming to the project that you've shortlisted, Songbirds is a good project. It's in two phases. It will be completed in March 2015. Phase two is also in advanced stages of construction, where they're handing over possession in 2016. It's just located 2.5 kilometers from the Mumbai-Bangalore highway. Developer has a decent track record, has delivered four projects in Pune already. Infrastructure is also reasonably okay. Coming to the key data points of this area, seven projects, 1,210 units, 10 months is the inventory overhang. This is what we refer to as the mid-segment, which is 4,900 rupees a square foot over here. Price appreciation charts depict a 34% price appreciation in this area over the last 2.5 years, or 13.5% on an annualized basis. Songbirds was your shortlisted project, which gets a go-ahead. It's by Sky One Developers in Bhugaon. 5,200 rupees a square foot is the price. Getting ready in 2016, available with the developer. And we've got two more projects for you over there. Forest Trails by the Highlands. This is Paranjpai Schemes, Bhugaon. 5,400 rupees a square foot is the price. This project is getting ready a year earlier, 2015. Available with the developer. This is a part of a 180-acre township. The second one is Bellbrook by Montworth Homes, Bhugaon. 4,833 rupees a square foot is the price. Again, the project is getting ready in 2016, available with the developer, and developer has a reasonably good reputation.
All right, so we're talking about a new market, micro market in Pune, Bhugaon, which of course is close to some of the well-settled IT areas as well. And here's a quick summary of what you can pick, because there are several township projects here. There's Forest Trails, the Highlands by Paranjpai Schemes that we like and has made into our shortlist. There's also Bellbrook Montworth Homes. And of course, the one that you've shortlisted, Neeraj, also gets a go-ahead from us. Songbirds by Sky Developers. And the developer has a reputation and has done some execution in Bangalore
projects.
As well.
Pune. He's delivered
all,
four projects
all in Pune?
Yeah.
Okay. In Pune, he's developed a couple of projects before this as well. Okay, let's take our next caller. There's Anand Ramadurai on the phone line with us. Anand, hi. Go ahead. Where do you want to buy?
Yeah, thanks a lot for taking my query. I am looking to actually buy a 3 BHK in Mumbai or Thane.
Okay.
And prima facie, Thane seems more affordable. My budget being a maximum of about 2 crores. I've seen and I've shortlisted some properties in Thane, which are Simzi Adriano, Dosi Imperia, and Runwal Irene. I just wanted to know how these properties are rated and whether I can go ahead and invest in one of them. And is it a good idea to invest in Thane and see significant investment returns, or is it already overrated?
Okay, now Thane, I do know that new launches have slowed down, but there's already a lot of projects under execution and the market has slowed down considerably, hasn't it? Prices have also mellowed, Sameer?
Yes, prices have mellowed, but not to that extent.
10-15%.
Yeah,
I mean, that's what we've
what
heard, not
happened.
More than that.
So when a developer launches 10-15% below launch price, he does manage to get a lot of buyers in, unlike many micro markets, I would say, where
right.
the drop has been much more substantial.
Yeah.
Having said that, the...
But that's the strange part about many of the Mumbai micro markets. The inventory overhang has increased. Sales have slowed down, but I don't think there's much room with the developers to bring down prices too much. So 10, 12, 15 is what you can negotiate across the table, or new launches would have come down, probably to a launch which has happened about 8 months ago.
I think Mumbai is the only real area where city as such, where, you know, the cost of replacement of land is higher because land in Mumbai has not just got released in any which way. They don't have much land as such, and most of it is coming under redevelopment, where, you know, it takes tens of years for a project to really get delivered. So that's why I think prices don't come down, especially of ready projects in Mumbai at all. Having said that, the three projects that you've shortlisted, all three are good projects. We've also culled out three projects in Kandivali East, since your requirement was also considering Mumbai. So we've taken the shot of giving you three more projects for Mumbai, so you can pick and choose. Although the three projects that you've shortlisted are in three different micro markets. Dosti Imperia is in Gorbanda Road. It's at 9850 rupees a square foot, 2015, available with the developer. You can go ahead with this project. Urbania Azanio by Rustam G Group is in Majiwara. This is at 10,000 rupees a square foot, 2015. Again, a good project, developed over 127 acres of land parcel in a township. So you can avail the benefits of the township. Erin by Ranwal Group is in Balcombe, 7499 rupees a square foot. 2017 is a completion year. Available with the developer. Again, the developer is reasonably reputed, so they get a go-ahead from our side. But I'll come to the key data points of Kandivali East, which is a micro market in Mumbai, which we've shortlisted three more projects for you, should you want to consider Mumbai as well. 17 projects there, 4620 units. 24 months is the inventory overhang here. The luxury segment today trades at 12,100 rupees a square foot, and you can afford that segment in Mumbai, which you were considering maybe Mumbai is out of your reach, but that's not really the case. 39% has been the price appreciation of Kandivali East over the last 2.5 years, or 14% on an annualized basis. Raheja Reflections Eternity by Raheja Universal, Kandivali East, 12,500 rupees a square foot is the price. 2015 is a completion year. Available with the developer. Then we have Alpine by Shapurji Palanji Group, Kandivali East, 11,150 rupees a square foot is the price. 2017 is the completion year. Available with the developer again. And then we have Oasis by Acme Group, Kandivali East, 11,500 rupees a square foot, 2017 being the completion year, and available with the developer.
All right, so some of your projects which have already actually made it into our shortlisted recommendations earlier on the program, get a go ahead. And here's what we'd also like you to look at in Kandivali, because we believe that you could own something closer to the center part of Mumbai. There's Raheja Reflections, Eternity, Raheja Universal, and there's Alpine, Shapoji Palanji, and Oasis by Acme Group. So three projects from us as well, so take a look at these. We've got Chandrasekhar Kumbar writing in to say, I want to buy a 1 BHK flat in Thane. Budget is 40 to 45 lakhs. I'm not keen to buy in the faraway areas from the station like Ghorbandar Road, Manpada or Kolshet Road. My wife works at Khopat and I work at Ambernath. Hence, my areas for preference are Khopat and surrounding areas, about 10 minutes driving distance. So, again, like, you know, you told, we discussed that point in terms of how if it's an affordable home or a mid-budget home, people should stay close to the traveling or connectivity. So either a station or a metro, etc. That's, I think, what his requirement is, Sameer.
Absolutely. But unfortunately, Khopat is now trading at a weighted average price of 10,500 rupees a square foot. So this price point does not suit Khopat at all. However, we've shortlisted Balcombe, which is a micro market, which is just 4 kilometers away from Khopat. Here also the options are very limited, but they're still there.
Okay.
We've got two more options for you. We just want to share the names and the price points there, because if you want to go 9 kilometers away from Khopat, those are the two options that are possible as well. Other than that, we would recommend you to consider this. The option that we have is just 4.5 kilometers from the Thane Junction and 1.5 kilometers from the Eastern Express Highway. So this is something that you can look at. Coming to the key data points, 7 projects here, total supply 2190 units, 8 months is the inventory overhang in Balcombe. The mid segment today is weighted average price is 8800 rupees a square foot. Price appreciation has also been reasonable, 41% over the last 2.5 years, or about 15% on an annualized basis. The other two projects that I was suggesting, which are 9 kilometers away, you may want to consider it, is Mahavir Kalpur Ruksha. This is 9 kilometers away at 7650 rupees a square foot, so they're cheaper. And Havare City, which is 6800 rupees a square foot. Coming to the recommendation from our side, NG Residency Regency by RNA Builders. This is in Balcombe, 6250 rupees a square foot. It's ready and it's available with the developer.
All right, so it's a ready property in your budget and, well, just about 4.5 kilometers away from where you've chosen, or the micro market you've chosen. Unfortunately, that's not fitting the budget that you've also specified. So hopefully you like this property. All right, there was a time when developers targeted only Mumbai's western regions, leaving the more remote locations in the east to be looked at as a second home option or for plot investments. But that's set to change now, thanks to a new master plan, which will see the EMD or the Eastern Mumbai district become the focal point of the city's next leg of urbanization. Ashish Bhatia travels to the region to find out whether this region is worth looking at as a new residential destination.
Up until the global recession in 2008, developers in Mumbai catered to high-income clientele who were keen on settling in the posh western regions of the city. But since then, market sentiments have changed. Developers are now targeting volume sales from the lower and mid-income group and are increasingly launching projects in remote locations on the outskirts of the city.
Going in the periphery, you know, you are in fact extending the economics of the Bombay. The migration of the industry from Mumbai main to the outskirts in the eastern Mumbai area will be freeing up a lot of area from Mumbai, which will be giving starved land to the Mumbai itself.
The economics behind looking east is simple. Mumbai's western regions are becoming an investor-driven market, with the result that prices here have gone beyond the reach of the aam aadmi. The government too is keen on relieving pressure from these regions and has been urging developers to develop to the last mile by spreading out to remote areas like the eastern Mumbai district. Little wonder then that the eastern Mumbai district is fast becoming a new buzzword in Mumbai's realty market. A look at the affordable micro markets in EMD shows how this socio-economic development has already sparked an upward trend in property prices. Nehru saw property prices appreciate year on year from 2,300 per square feet in the first quarter of 2011 by 39% up to fourth quarter of 2013. Prices in Karjat appreciated over 26%. Last but not the least, leading the pack is Khopoli Belt with an over 47% price appreciation in the same period. A recent financial report claims that the turnaround has only begun. Based on trends seen in Navi Mumbai and Panvel, it is estimated that the property prices will give an incredible 900% appreciation in 16 years.
This entire area is not just a play on real estate, but it's also a play on the industrial growth of not just India, but of Maharashtra as well. You also see that the infrastructure projects are not just related to purely commuter travel, but also for industrialization and for the logistics, which is a very huge growth.
A major factor for developers looking east are the number of major infrastructure projects that have boosted access to the eastern Mumbai district. 8-lane freeway connector between the Island City and Pune Expressway, and then the ambitious 8-lane Trans-Harbour Link from Navasheva JNPT port to Shivri. The 8-lane state road of Kalyan Murbad Kashale Road is expected to drastically decrease commuting time between Kalyan and Karjat, a reason prices here have already appreciated. While development is definitely around the corner, experts say the time span in which these projects are completed that will prove to be a major deterrent for investors in the region, a factor that buyers will have to keep in mind in order to better gauge the returns on their investments. Which is why for potential investors in this region, experts are advising caution.
It could be long before the eastern Mumbai district becomes the goose that lays the golden egg. Since the real estate market is completely a speculation-driven market, the idea is to catch the pulse of these emerging markets and to clearly understand when to enter a market and when to exit a market. Impulsive buying in this case is simply a big, big no. With camera person Rakesh Solanki and Chandradai, Ashish Bhatia for IndyTV.
All right, we keep trying to cull out new micro markets in regions which are catching developers and investors' fancy. So go ahead and take a look at EMD in Mumbai if you are a Mumbai resident. Meanwhile, coming up next, best plotted developments in Gurgaon under 2 crore rupees. What are your options? Good news, because we just love green with a passion. India has crossed 2 billion square feet of green building footprint. We tell you the benefits of going green with a very special guest on the show today.